Then we have the story that is made mention of in Tafsir al-Tabari by Qatada rahimahullah. He says the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was instructed at the very beginning to get up on Mount Safa and to call the people of Quraysh, the various clans, the leaders of the clans and the cronies, and to address them from Mount Safa. So he got up to Mount Safa, he called them, everybody came. The reason they all came is they knew him as a good man, an honest man, the trustworthy, the most, for example, honest, the one who was the best of the lot, the one who did not speak a lie, the one who was really high in rank and so on. They knew him as a good man. When he gathered them, I have something very important to tell you, they all came. So then he gathered up on Mount Safa and he asked them a question. He says, "O people of Quraysh, if I were to tell you that behind me on this side of the hill is an army that is ready to attack you, would you believe what I have to say?" They said, "Yes, we've never known you to tell a lie. We would immediately believe." He says, "So my people, I am here warning you of a severe punishment. Worship Allah and Allah alone. Quit your idols and quit your bad ways and habits." Immediately they became angry, they became upset. I'm sure you've heard of Abu Lahab and what he said. He said, "Woe be to you, destruction be to you, O Muhammad. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection." These are bad statements that were made mention of and repeated in the Quran for us to take lesson from. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then makes mention of the statements that the people of Quraysh said. They said, "This man is a madman and this man is possessed. Don't listen to him. Moments ago he was the best of the lot. He was the top. He was the most trustworthy. Just because of one thing that did not suit them, one thing that was the honest, brutal truth, they did not want it. Immediately they said, he's a bad man." Let's ask ourselves, how many of us, we have friends, we have family members, we have people close to us. When they tell us one thing that is really correct, subhanAllah, we tend to hate them. We dislike them. "I don't want." The reason is, why are you telling me this? You're supposed to be my friend. I'm not supposed to be listening to this from you. Well, if you're a true friend, my brothers and sisters, if you're a faithful spouse, you will be honest. You will correct your spouse even if he or she happens to feel hurt about it. May Allah help us and grant us a lesson from this beautiful verse. Verse number 184 of Surah Al-A'raf. أَوَلَمْ يَتَفَكَّرُوا مَا بِصَاحِبِهِمْ مِنْ جِنَّةٍ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا نَذِيرٌ مُبِينٌ. Do they not ponder? Do they not think? Their companion is not a possessed person or a madman. Not at all. In fact, he is a plain warner. He's just come to warn them. One of the most powerful ways of understanding the truthfulness of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is he never ever called towards himself. Not once. He always called towards Allah. If he was a madman, if he was after position or power or anything else, he would have blown his own trumpet to say, "Everyone, worship me. I am the big boss. I am the man. I am the greatest. I am this." Not once did he speak about himself. But rather he always said, "Worship the one who made you. Worship Allah alone. I am only a messenger. I have come to convey the message," and so on. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us beautiful lessons.